Good afternoon. Please rise as the students process in and remain standing for our invocation. Let's pray together. Dear Lord, you have been so faithful and good to each one of us during our time in nursing school. We know because of who you are that you will continue to be gracious towards us as we take this next step in our lives. Thank you for how you have shown us more of yourself and our successes and our failures. You have shown us your strength and presence in the long nights of studying, the tiredness after an early morning clinical, and the test grades that weren't where we wanted them to be. You have demonstrated to us the giving of your undeserved blessings in a patient's smile and in the privilege to care for those patients in their time of greatest need. Thank you for each person you placed in our lives that has supported us emotionally, financially, and mentally to get to this point, parents, friends, and professors. Thank you, Lord, for each one of the faculty members here who demonstrated your grace towards us in so many ways. Thank you for how you have used them in growing and challenging us to become the best that we can be. They supported us every step of the way and have led us to where we are standing today. Encourage each one of the faculty members as they continue to teach the next generation of nurses. Show them how to lead and guide as godly nursing leaders. Thank you, Lord, for being a light through us, your children, and using us as messengers of your word to every patient we are able to care for. And moving forward into our careers as nurses, I pray you would continue to work in and through each one of us for your glory. Help us to keep you as our purpose and at the center of all we do. Let us not forget your purpose for us as nurses. Let us not think of it as simply a job, but a divine calling. As your word says, every person who calls in your name and believes in Christ's sacrifice for us on the cross will be saved. We know that this is the message that each person you have saved is called to take to every nation. I pray that no busyness, heavy patient load, or conflict with coworkers will cloud this message, this calling you have for each of your divinely called nurses. May it be ever so evident in every touch, every injection, and every word. I lift up our time together this afternoon in this ceremony commemorating what you have done for us these past few years. I pray that we would not receive the glory, for it is not by our own doing that we are here, but that you would be glorified for who you are and what you have done. Jesus, it is in your awesome and holy name we pray. Amen.
Thank you. You may be seated. Good afternoon. As all of you here know, and for those of you that may not, I'm Dr. Andrea Meyer. I'm the Dean of the College of Nursing on behalf of Charleston Southern University and the faculty and staff of our nursing program. It is my pleasure to welcome you here today for our nursing lamp and pinning ceremony. Today, we are honoring and celebrating the May 2021 class of undergraduate students who are receiving a Bachelor of Science in Nursing degree. So I want to first begin by congratulating all of our graduates today. Well done, and today belongs to you, and you have all worked diligently to reach this stage. We know that this past year has proven to be challenging, and all of us have been forced to adapt the ways in which we teach and in the ways in which we learn. Last year, at the beginning of 2020, the World Health Organization declared the year as the year of the nurse. This was done to honor the 200th anniversary of Florence Nightingale's birth and to celebrate the many ways in which the roles of nurses and the contributions of nurses advance health and the welfare of people in every nation around the world. It was Florence herself who popularized the 6-foot rule of infection control, hand washing, and maintaining social distancing. In the many ways that things have changed since this time, 200 years ago, many of these ideas have remained the same. It was completely unexpected that this past year would also be the year of an international health crisis. Throughout history, the nursing profession has played major roles in stepping into times of crisis and providing care and innovation that has saved lives and reduced suffering. And the situation we are in now is no different. Nurses make up more than half of the healthcare workforce worldwide. And the world today faces a shortage of nearly 9 million nurses. As you have all seen the events of this past year unfold, it is no surprise to any of us in this room that nurses continue to be recognized as being on the front lines of healthcare. Each of you should feel an immense sense of pride and responsibility to answer the call of duty before you as you are preparing to courageously care for patients in extreme circumstances. You are the most visible asset during this crisis. The world's awareness of the work that nurses do every day is higher today than ever before. I hope that you will take all that you've learned in this program and all of the wisdom imparted from you from your faculty on your journey. And I hope you thoughtfully and confidently shape this profession and guide it in the work that you do. Today is a testament to your ability to really rise above these great challenges. I also want to offer a heartfelt thank you to everyone here today that has supported our graduates. We really recognize the importance that your support has had on our individual graduates here today, so we thank you. The College of Nursing is fortunate to have several endowed nursing scholarships to assist our students as they progress towards their degree. These scholarships are listed on the back of your programs. They have been established by individuals, families, and other groups who have given selflessly to support the success of our students. Many of our graduates could not achieve their dream without your support. Now there are a few people here this afternoon that I would like to recognize. A special group of people that have been dedicated and supportive of our students and worked tirelessly to ensure the success of them this year are our nursing faculty and staff. So faculty and staff, would you please stand so we can recognize you? I would also like to recognize our president, Dr. Dondi Costin, who's here with us. Thank you, Dr. Costin. And I would like to ask Dr. Costin to come forward and address our graduates today, if he doesn't mind. Thank you. Appreciate it. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, you are but two ceremonies away from your dream. Two different ceremonies. One has air conditioning and one does not. And perhaps the more important element for most of you who will be pinned today, one has high heels and one does not. Thank you for hearing God's voice, listening to his call. Because this is a calling. And there is a rigor to every academic program at Charleston Southern. But there is a particular rigor to nursing school. Because you have to do in the classroom and the clinic the things that are going to make a difference in people's lives and in their health for the rest of their lives and the rest of yours, God willing. I'm grateful to you because I could not do what you're about to do. I say that with no humility other than to say I don't have the guts to see blood and guts the way that you have been called to do so. And I thank God for you. I thank God for you because as the president of this university, I'm a bit of a softy, and I wish as the president this program was easier. I know you do too. But there's a more important part of me that is so thankful to all of you and all of you that it isn't. That part of me is not the president, it's the patient. And as a patient, I hope that you didn't cut any corners. If you did, I hope you made note of the corners that you cut and that in the next few months you will go and make sure you know exactly what you're doing and those you know what I'm talking about. And I hope you do. Because you have been called to help people who cannot help themselves. And I hope that you will never lose sight of that. I hope that as you walk into a clinic or a hospital or wherever you find yourself, or maybe an elementary school someday. I hope you will walk into that school or that institution, that hospital, and every single day what I hope you will say to yourself is that God has called me to this. He has called me to help people who can't help themselves. And if they can't do it, then I have been called to do it on their behalf, and I hope you will do that. I hope you will never think of your profession as a career or a paycheck or anything else other than what you've been called to do. And as I finish today, I want to read these words because after Jesus's particular graduation, He was sent to a church, a synagogue. And he was handed a Bible. And the scroll of the prophet Isaiah was handed to him here in Luke chapter 4, verse 17. Unrolling it, he found the place where it is written, "The Spirit of the Lord is on me, because he has anointed me to preach good news to the poor." What I also hope you will do, I hope everyone will get a prayer, a copy of the prayer that was just prayed at the beginning of this ceremony. Because you read that about once a week, this is all you will need. "He has sent me to proclaim freedom for the prisoners and recovery of sight for the blind, to release the oppressed, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor." And then he rolled up the scroll, gave it back to the attendant, and sat down. The eyes of everyone in the synagogue were fastened on him in a way that every eye will be fastened upon you today as you cross this stage and you receive the pen and you receive the lamp. The eyes of everyone in the synagogue were fastened on him. And he began by saying to them, "Today, this scripture is fulfilled in your hearing." Nurses, by virtue of you receiving these accessories to your wardrobe today, you are saying, in no uncertain terms, to all of us, but to every patient in whose eyes you will ever look, today, this scripture is fulfilled in your hearing. God bless you all. You're probably going to need it. Amen.
Thank you, Dr. Costin. Today, each of our undergraduates have placed a red rose in the vase, symbolizing their joining of the profession of nursing. Our nursing faculty are symbolized by the white roses. On behalf of the faculty, I congratulate each of the graduates on their achievement in the profession for which we have committed our lives. The faculty and I look forward to working with you as our nursing colleagues. And now we come to a special part of our program where the class of 2021 graduates are presented with the CSU Nursing Pin. I invite Ms. Andrea Raines, one of our faculty members, to share with you the history of our nursing pin.
Since 1860, when Florence Nightingale was awarded the Red Cross of St. George for her selfless service to the injured and dying during the Crimean War, pinning ceremonies have come to represent the momentous rite of passage from student to practitioner. Each graduate receives a school pin that is worn proudly after graduation at work when the graduate now becomes a registered nurse. Each nursing program has a special, individualized pin that symbolizes the essence of the university, college, and nursing program. Today, we award the Charleston Southern University Nursing Pin to our graduates. The oval pin is a beautiful symbol of the university and the program. The front of the pin has a CSU blue border with Charleston Southern University in gold sweeping across from left to right. At the bottom of the blue border is BSN for the degree. The center of the pin is a brushed gold representation of the CSU seal, which symbolizes the mission of the university, integrating faith in learning, leading, and serving. The open book, the Bible, the lamp of knowledge, and the cross. One unique thing about this pin is what is on the back. If you look at the official CSU seal on publications, you will notice that there is scripture surrounding the seal. The scripture is from Matthew 28, verse 19, which says, "Go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit." Due to space, we were not able to put the scripture on the front of the pin with the other seal symbols. So on the back of the pin is engraved a portion of the scripture, "Go ye and teach." In addition to the scripture, each student's initials and the year of graduation are also engraved. Front and back, the pin represents so well the university and the nursing program.
Today we also have a special addition to our ceremony, a blessing of the hands. Psalms 24, verse 4 states, "The one who has clean hands and a pure heart, they will receive a blessing from the Lord." The work of our hands is among the best expressions we share with the people to whom we offer care. These graduates have answered the call to service because they care about people, physically, emotionally, and spiritually. Today, we offer a blessing of their hands. After receiving their nursing pin, the graduates will each receive their blessing on behalf of the South Carolina Baptist Nursing Fellowship. It is my pleasure now to introduce Ms. Debbie Ackerman, president of the Baptist Nursing Fellowship, to explain the blessing of the hand ceremony.
Graduates, our Baptist Nursing Fellowship is honored to be with you on this important day. The blessing of the hands for nurses as they graduate is a timeless tradition, and in this ceremony, we pass on the blessing given to us, as well as the accountability that's been placed in us to use our hands with great care as we practice our nursing arts. Nurses, look at your hands. Some of your hands are young and smooth, just beginning to write your nursing story. Some of your hands are a little bit older and already have marks of serving, a history of caring and healing written over time. Other hands are somewhere between in your nursing journey. The hands of a nurse are one of the most important assessment tools, strong hands, yet gentle hands, empowered by the passion of our profession. Hands detect skin temperature, hydration, and edema. Hands are a mode of treatment to calm an upset patient, hold pressure on wounds to steady the aged, welcome a new life into this world, and comfort someone as they leave their earthly home. Nurses' hands are those that even when wrung out by exhaustion or overwhelmed by too many tasks to do, will never be too busy to reach out to our patients with tenderness that nurses convey with just a touch. God has blessed each of you with the gift of nursing. Some of you already know the path that you will take. Some of you are still exploring where nursing will ultimately take you. Trust God's direction, and you will find your calling and your way. Proverbs 3, 5, and 6 reminds us that we can trust in the Lord with all our heart. Lean not on your own understanding, it says. In all your ways acknowledge him, and he will direct your path. As your patients put their trust in your hands, place your trust in God's holy hands. The blessing of your hands with water and towel is significant. The towel represents serving, the water healing, and just as Jesus took up a towel and with a basin of water demonstrated a servant spirit, so too should you be his servant to the patients you care for each day.
Let us pray. Blessed be these hands that touch lives with healing. Blessed be these hands that sense and ease pain. Blessed be these hands that embrace with compassion. Blessed be these hands that draw blood, start IVs, and administer medicines. Blessed be these hands that wash patients, clean beds, and dispose of waste. Blessed be these hands that comfort the dying and hold the dead. Blessed be these hands today and for each future day in nursing. Blessed be these hands, for they are the work of your creative hands, O holy God. Amen.
Thank you. At this time, it gives me a great deal of pride to present the CSU Bachelor of Science in Nursing pins to the graduating class of 2021. Each student will be individually recognized. In addition to receiving a pin, the students will also each receive a lamp. Florence Nightingale, known as the founder of modern nursing, has a very interesting history on how it relates to the nursing lamp. So I invite Dr. Carrie Nelson to share with you the history of Florence Nightingale and the nursing lamp.
Florence Nightingale sensed from an early age that nursing was her calling from God,
and today is considered the pioneer of modern nursing due to her courageousness and devotion to nursing soldiers back to health during the Crimean War, where she was put in charge of nursing. She carried a lamp as she walked the halls of the battlefield hospital and became known as the Lady with the Lamp. She stayed up late at night checking the ailing soldiers in the hospital that she helped to maintain, and she always had a kind and compassionate spirit about her. She saved thousands of lives, and people called her a ministering angel. After the war was over, Florence returned to London and helped to establish the first formal nursing school. As a tribute to Florence's dedication, the lamp icon has become a symbolic of nursing. The lamp will always shine brightly as a symbol of the care and devotion the nurse administers to the sick and injured in the practice of nursing.
I have asked Dr. Cindy Dyson, our undergraduate program director, to come forward to assist in the presentation of the pins. Mrs. Christina Heaton will present the students with their lamps. Graduates, please come forward as your name is called, and you may remove your mask while you're being pinned.
Get ready? Okay. Elizabeth Albright. Lydia Ayers. Carly Bedell. Kayla Betancourt. Kylie Bibler. Valerie Boast. Perry Broad. Alyssa Carroll. Bruce Chesson. Marlene Contreras. Micah Corbin. Shauna K. Davis. Savannah Fairchild. Madison Fisher. Taylor Gray. Teresa Hanley. Mackenzie Justice. Abby Keller. Jessica Ketchum. Savannah Kingery. Cameron Kosiewski. Chelsea Levi. Sydney Link. Megan Lohman. Morgan Mansfield. Suzanne MacArthur. Caitlin Mead. Nina Murchison. Dylan Murphy. Tiara Nick. Alyssa Ott. Autumn Phillips. Bailey Pratt. Anna Marie Ringer. Grace Swanevelt. Isabella Skelly. Journey Simpson Brown. Annalise Taggart. Noah Thomas. Alyssa Wander. Nathan Way. Christopher Hunter Wilson.
graduates. You're all standing, but I was going to say, please stand so we can recognize you one more time. You may be seated. Congratulations again. I now invite Ms. Susan Weick to speak to you about Sigma Theta Tau.
Good afternoon. Sigma Theta Tau is the International Honor Society for Nursing. Members of Sigma Theta Tau represent the best of the best in nursing. The name of our local chapter is Gamma Omicron at Large, and we would like to recognize the graduates who were recently inducted into this prestigious society this fall. Inductees, would you please stand? Thank you. You may be seated. Involvement in Sigma Theta Tau is extremely rewarding, and I encourage each of you to become actively involved in the chapter and the international activities of the society. Congratulations to each one of you.
I am very proud of our chapter of the Student Nurses Association, Alpha Nu Omega. They are active in community service, volunteering, and donating resources. They have won awards at state conventions, and we also have had members serving in state and national leadership roles. I would like to introduce Mrs. Lori Tisdale, Mrs. Julia Ferguson, two of our undergraduate faculty members, and also SNA faculty advisors, to recognize our graduating members.
The Alpha Nu Omega chapter of Student Nurses Association is an opportunity for students to engage with both healthcare and community organizations, developing both personally and professionally, as well as to represent CSU nursing to other organizations. Students earn points based on their high level of participation in monthly meetings and community service projects. Those who earn enough points earn an SNA cord for graduation. The following students have earned an SNA graduation cord. Please come forward. Kylie Bibler. Valerie Boast. Shauna K. Davis. Taylor Gray. Megan Lohman. Nina Murchison. And Alyssa Ott. Additionally, some students take on additional roles in SNA, serving in a variety of leadership roles. These students put an enormous amount of time and energy to run this outstanding group. The following students have earned both a STOL and an SNA Leadership Cord. Kayla Betancourt. Bruce Chesson. Micah Corbin. Savannah Fairchild. Mackenzie Justice. Abby Keller. Chelsea Levi. And Anna Marie Ringer.
Thank you, students. I would like to introduce Dr. Vicki Ball to speak to you a little bit about the Nurses Christian Fellowship.
The Student Nurses Christian Fellowship, or NCF, is an organization that assists nursing students in growing in love for God, God's Word, God's people of every ethnicity and culture, and God's purposes in the world. In addition to balancing a full workload of nursing courses, clinicals, a job, personal relationships, one senior student took on the challenge of leading the CSU chapter over the last 2 years. It is my privilege to present Bruce Chesson with a Nurse's Bible in recognition of his dedication and service as an NCF leader.
I am pleased now to invite Mrs. Kimberly Downing to present the Senior Awards.
It's nice to take that off for a second. The Excellence in Nursing Award is given to the student that the faculty believes exhibits overall outstanding performance in nursing. This award was announced at the University Awards Day earlier this month, and today we are delighted to present our recipient with her award. The recipient of the 2021 BSN Excellence in Nursing Award is Journey Simpson Brown. Journey. The Academic Excellence Award is given to a senior nursing student who demonstrates excellence in academic achievement and scholarship. This year, we had two students selected to receive this award. The recipients of this year's Academic Excellence Awards are Marlene Contreras and Nathan Way. Marlene and Nathan. Clinical Excellence Award is awarded to a senior nursing student who demonstrates outstanding clinical competence, integrates the values, beliefs, and ethics of nursing in clinical practice, and demonstrates a caring and compassionate attitude. This year, the faculty selected three nursing students to receive this award. The recipients of the Clinical Excellence Award are Bruce Chesson, Grace Svanevelt, and Savannah Fairchild. The Nursing Service Award is awarded to a senior nursing student who demonstrates outstanding service to the school, university, nursing, and the community. This year, the faculty selected three students to receive this award. This year's recipients of the Nursing Service Award are Abby Keller, Jessica Ketchum, and Kayla Betancourt. If you would come up.
Congratulations, students. And now I would like to invite some of our graduates today to share some of their thoughts and memories. Savannah and Abby, could you please come forward?
Good afternoon. My name is Savannah.
And my name is Abby.
And we are honored to be up here speaking in front of all of you today.
I would like to open today by reciting the nurse's prayer. As I pray for my patients today, be there with me, O Lord, I pray. Make my words kind, it means so much, and in your hands place your healing touch. Let your love shine through in all I do, so those who are in need may hear you, feel you, see you in me. Amen. And as I reflect on this simple prayer, I cannot help but think on how fast we've developed as nursing students into new graduate nurses. Less than 2 years ago, our maximum level of care for patients was getting vitals and obtaining a health assessment. Our only prayer then was, Lord, please help me get out of here without crying in front of Miss Dial.
And we thought those times were hard.
Can you believe that about a year ago today, we were completely in the dark about what healthcare was going to look like, let alone our education at CSU? As faculty and students, we can say we have truly endured one of the most difficult times in our lives. The definition of endured is to have suffered patiently or remained in existence. So many of our days were filled with patience and flexibility, looking into how healthcare and education would change for us. Many days felt like they simply passed by as we sat on a computer screen, but I know we all learned one monumentally important lesson: how to split screen on the computer so we could watch Netflix and do Zoom at the same time.
That is absolutely one of the greatest lessons I learned while in nursing school. I completely agree with Abby. As she spoke on the word endure, I was reminded of the Bible verse Hebrews 12:1, which says, "Therefore, since we are surrounded by such a great cloud of witnesses, let us throw off everything that hinders and the sin that so easily entangles. Let us run with perseverance the race set out for us." I think this verse should be the motto for nursing school. We have persevered and made it to the end. I also love how the verse mentions a great cloud of witnesses. To me, these witnesses are all of you who are celebrating with us here today, all of our peers that have become our friends and our family, and to our professors who have helped us get to this pinning ceremony. To speak on some of our professors, I know everybody will agree with me when I say that if it wasn't for the unearthly, soothing voice of Mrs. Downing, we would have never made it past first semester. To Mrs. Dial, thank you for being one of the first professors to ask us why.
And if it wasn't for Mrs. Wall, our clinical paperwork would still be so below average. And thankfully, we had Mrs. Bullock to remind us to laugh at ourselves along the way. And if it wasn't for Mrs. Weick's intensely thorough notes, we would have all failed Adult Health 1. And if it wasn't for Mrs. Collins' bright and chipper spirit, we would have all fallen asleep during our 8 a.m.s.
If it wasn't for Mrs. Warren and Mrs. Moeller, we would have never learned where babies came from. If it wasn't for Dr. Nelson and Dr. Ferguson, we would have never learned to be the kick-butt nurses that we are today. If it wasn't for Mrs. Tisdale's endless guidance, I know I personally would have never made it through nursing school.
And if it wasn't for Dr. Singleton, we would have never learned how to truly be empathetic. And if it wasn't for Mrs. Van and Ms. Heaton, we would have never learned how to debrief and talk about our feelings. And if it wasn't for Mrs. Kaysen, we would have never learned how to not be deathly afraid of children.
If it wasn't for Mrs. Schlett, I would have never made it to my clinicals downtown because I was completely lost on Rutledge Avenue and had to FaceTime her multiple times at 6 o'clock in the morning.
Without Mrs. Raines and Ms. Arnold, we would have never been able to make the transition from virtual learning to the real world. And to Ms. Hathcock, you are the reason we have passed the drug dosage up to this point.
To Dr. Dyson and Dr. Meyer, thank you for preparing us so well for the NCLEX. If it wasn't for Dr. Jorgensen and Dr. Ball, I would have never been made aware of how truly awful I am at APA format. And to Mrs. Williams, we are so glad we got to learn from you when we did, because you taught us all about
coronavirus. And we all just want to say thank you to Ms. Tinley and Ms. Cole for helping us enter into the program, to Ms. Davies for always helping us with sim and lab days, and to Ms. Pitzinger for literally being the glue that holds us all together.
We said that one more. In conclusion of our professors, we want to give out a special shout out to Mrs. Timko. While we never had you as a professor, we've heard great things. And to Mrs. Brumback, Mrs. Schimmick, and Mrs. Crane, they will always hold a special place in our hearts forever and ever. I truly cannot believe we have made it to the light at the end of the tunnel. I speak on behalf of our entire cohort when I say we have all never studied, worked, tried, and sometimes failed as hard as we have while enduring this program. And boy, does it feel good to say that we have finally passed the finish line. I have grown to know each person within our cohort, and in my biased opinion, I think we absolutely have the best group to have ever walked the halls of CSU's nursing building. And just to reflect on some of our great memories, we would love if you take a look at this video we put together.
Papers, Hope when you take that jump, you don't feel the fall. Hope when the water rises, you build a wall. Hope when the crowd screams out, you're screaming your name. Hope if everybody runs, you choose to stay. Hope that you fall in love and it hurts so bad. Say
see clearly. If anybody asks you who I am, just stand up tall, look them in the face and say, I'm that star up in the sky, I'm that mountain peak up high. Hey, I made it, I'm the world's greatest. And I'm that little bit of hope, when my back's against the ropes, I can feel it. World's greatest. The world's greatest, Joe. The world's greatest. Ever. I am a giant. I am an eagle. Oh, I am a lion. Down in the jungle. I am a marching band. I am the people. Oh, I am a helping hand. I am a hero. If anybody asks you who I am, just stand up tall, look them in the face and say, I'm that star up in the sky, I'm that mountain peak up high. Hey, I made it, I'm the world's greatest. And I'm that little bit of hope, when my back's against the ropes, I can feel it. The world's greatest.
Together, 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 everyone. Together, together, come on, let's have some.
This concludes our program for this afternoon. In parting, I thank you, graduates, and I extend best wishes to you for a fulfilling career in nursing. And I hope that you always see your role as a nurse as a duty, a privilege, and an opportunity to serve. I hope you will stay in touch with us and CSU and the College of Nursing. Following the benediction by grace, you will recess and the ceremony will be adjourned.
First Corinthians 15:58 says, "Therefore, my beloved brethren, be steadfast, immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, knowing that your labor is not in vain in the Lord." Please pray with me as we close this ceremony. Father, as we celebrate this transition today from student nurses to members of this profession, we praise you for your faithfulness to carry us through to today. Father, I pray for you to give this cohort the strength we need in this new role we now take on. Guide our hands as we hold new life entering the world, or as we are the last to hold the hand before death. Give us strength and guide our feet as we walk into the hospital each day, not for praise and applause, but striving to bring healing and wholeness. Clear our minds and provide wisdom as we apply years of studying to the best practice for our patients. Bless our words as we speak to the family after a terminal diagnosis. Give us courage as we are bold to question decisions that will bring harm. Above all, Father, let us be your light in darkness at our workplaces to patients, families, and coworkers. Instead of striving for power, importance, or influence, let us reflect Christ, striving at the end for you to proclaim, "Well done, good and faithful servants." When through the deep waters I call you to go, the rivers of sorrow shall not overflow, for I will be with you, your troubles to bless, and sanctify to you your deepest distress. When through fiery trials your pathway shall lie, my grace, all sufficient, shall be your supply. The flame shall not hurt you, I only design your dross to consume and the gold to refine. In Jesus' name, amen.